time in the 90s, and it was really advertised unlike any other.
Aloha. Aloha. Today is,
It's September 12th.
Today's September 12th. You're listening to the Pixel Power Up Podcast. I am your host, Kevin Allen, as always. And as always, I have with me...
Tizana Saldana.
And Wesley Babcock.
And we're here to talk about video games and stuff. I've been playing video games. Have you guys been playing video games?
I've been doing homework.
Bummer.
Yeah. I've actually been playing video games.
You've been playing video games? What video games have you been playing, Sana?
I went back to Infamous Second Son.
Hey, that's a good game.
It's a good game. It's a good game.
Yes.
Social justice.
I remember lukewarm reactions to that game.
It's a good game. It's a
Second Son. That's the hipster one, right?
That's the hipster one. Yeah. With the Native American.
And he's in Seattle.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The graphics, I think, at the time it came out, that was the thing that everybody was focusing on.
Yeah, that was the big PS4 game, right?
Yeah, you could see the smoke coming out of it. Yeah, remember that?
You know what? I remember that E3. I was super impressed by that presentation where he, like, gets all crazy with the smoke. Mm-hmm. Yeah, how are you enjoying that?
I've played all the Infamous. Infamous is, like, Uncharted for me. I just always play it.
Okay.
But, it's really good, and I'm not the type of person that ever completes a game, so there's just side missions I've never done. It's good. It's good and relaxing.
Yeah.
Reminds me of The Last Airbender, because you just do that all the time.
Yeah. You just do this to relax.
Yeah.
Just play Infamous.
Yeah.
That's cool. Yeah. Playing any other?
Tetris.
Oh, just more Tetris.
Just more Tetris.
How's your Tetris game going?
Tetris is going really good.
Yeah.
You should do versus mode one day, and I will play any of you in Tetris.
I'm pretty bad at Tetris. Wesley?
I haven't played in so long.
Yeah, it's
Let's
been...
Let's go, then. It's been years. For me.
Just what?
Yeah, it's Sana just wants to stomp us. Yeah.
Yes.
How's homework, Wesley?
It was good. I actually thought I have played some Bloodborne.
Oh, no shit.
Recently. Yeah, with some friends.
Hey, that's a video game.
Yeah.
How's it
going?
It's like the first boss.
Yeah.
It was pretty fun.
How are you liking that?
Yeah, I enjoy it. I was playing on their PS4, so.
Oh, okay. You play any other the Souls games? I know that's not a Souls game, but play any of those kinds of games?
I mean, fantasy is not my, like, favorite genre.
Sure.
So, but it was a fun game, so.
All right, cool. How's school, you guys? Dude, we're on, like, this is our, the first month?
Yeah, it's done already. The first month.
Dude.
School is...
Time is flying. I'm only failing one class. Nailing it!
I don't know, school
Success
is...
Success in life.
I'm working in a lab, so if you look at my Google calendar, it's like every day. I have participants that come in, and I'm just like,
What lab? We probably shouldn't say.
No. Oh,
well,
personal details.
Yeah.
Shouldn't be shared on the internet.
Right, but I work in a lab.
That's cool. I also work in a lab.
Oh, you do?
Yeah. Do you work in a lab, Wesley?
No.
A loser.
I know, I'm left out. What is this?
You should get in a lab. It's fun.
Yeah, it's not bad. It's real cold in there.
It's so cold. We'll talk more about our labs later.
Yeah.
When,
not on a video camera.
Yeah.
So I've been playing Jotun. Valhalla Edition on the PlayStation 4, which I said I was going to play last week. Mm-hmm. And I picked up, and you can see more on my review, which will be on Kaleo, pretty soon. I've been pretty busy to write it, but it's really good looking. Greek mythology is so cool. Or, I'm sorry, not Greek, Norse mythology.
Mm-hmm.
I just, I love everything about it. But, I don't know. The boss fights are really cool. I feel like that's a big thing about that game, is that its boss fights are really... kind of gigantic, and it's a, the bosses are huge, so you're this tiny person, so there's a really cool sense of scale there. But the stages in between the boss fights, like literally the rest of the game, not a big fan.
Well, I mean, kind of as a letdown after you have your David versus Goliath fight, and then
you just
hack at someone my height.
Yeah, exactly. Or like, it's not even that, it's just like, I don't know, go through kind of like a boring stage that's like,
Yeah,
I mean, it's cool, though. I like it. I still do like it. I think this is meant to be like a, more like a speedrunning game. Because I played for 2 hours, and I was like 3/4 of the way done. So I think it's definitely meant to be a game that's supposed to be like, you're supposed to practice the bosses and know everything about them and then like speedrun it. Yeah.
Right through them all.
Just kill them all. But yeah. So a review will be up pretty soon. That's already a pretty old game, to be fair. I think that game came out last year, but this new Valhalla Edition came out for all the home consoles, so I thought I would take a look at it. I've also been reading. This is sort of like video games. Hey, whoa. I read every night, you guys.
Do you?
Yeah, 30 minutes a day.
Do you?
Yeah.
Wow.
What do you read?
I've been reading the Warhammer series.
Oh, okay. My God.
Yeah, I've been going through the Horus Heresy, which I've been way into. I finished that first book in like a day and a half. Mm-hmm. I was so stoked about it. So I'm on the second book now. There's like 40 books, though. So I may never get through the Horus Heresy.
They're pretty dense.
They're all like 300-400 pages.
Wow, I didn't know this about you.
Why do people always say that? I'm a well-read individual.
You just don't strike me as a reader. Not that that's a bad thing.
What is that supposed to mean?
Wesley doesn't...
Do I look like some f***ing Neanderthal to you? Big f***ing club in my hand? Jesus. I'm the host of this podcast. I get no respect.
I feel...
My audio is spiking.
Do you want to know what's funny? I showed my mom our last podcast when
I'm so sorry.
When I interrupted you, she's like, "Don't interrupt him. His voice is better than yours." And I was like, "Mom, it's true.
It's true. Our office lady asked me if I could do the
voicemail.
No,
the voicemail.
I'm like, I mean, that'd be a good
it's
use.
Not 1990 anymore.
Oh.
Whoa,
they still have one, probably.
I still have a voicemail.
I do too, but it's just the robot. One. The robot does it now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I remember my voicemail. This was my first year of college. I hadn't changed my voicemail from my first year of high school. And that was before my voice got deep. So I like listened to my voicemail and it sounded like a little girl picked up the phone. Because I was still like midway through puberty. Not even midway. I hadn't even started puberty. Like, yeah, it was crazy. What were we talking about?
I'm glad that you read, though. No, I mean...
Yeah, I love to read.
That's awesome.
No, it's
reading
awesome.
Is good for you. Gosh, I wrote a whole article on why people should read.
Wow.
And its benefits. Christ, I don't know why people don't think I read. Do I look illiterate?
No, you just
don't look like
you don't look
that
like
reads.
Someone who reads
I
either.
I read a lot too, though.
He looks like yeah. I don't know.
Do I look like I read?
Yeah, because everyone looks like they read because they have eyes. That's racist. You know what was racist?
It's not racist.
You know what was racist?
All white.
I went to a Panda Express and they didn't even ask. They gave me a fork. Like, whoa. I'm half Korean. Excuse me. I can use chopsticks. Freaking racist, man.
They always give me a fork and I appreciate it because I'm not good with chopsticks.
Really?
I'm not good with it.
I prefer chopsticks over forks.
Yeah, I like chopsticks too.
Do you have any Asian in you?
No, I'm full white.
Okay. I have
full
Asian.
White?
Full white?
Filipino. That's my only Asian.
Okay. Yeah. But that's still some. More than zero.
More than zero.
I think that was a song in the 80s. No, less than zero. Was
less
it?
Than less zero. Yeah. Was, yeah. All right, cool.
It's a great start.
Great start. So that's what we've been playing.
We found out I'm prejudiced.
Yeah.
As readers.
Absolutely. Now let's talk about video game news. I still don't.
Dun, 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 dun.
That's true. That's bad.
Yeah, that sounds like someone just got murdered.
It looks like bad news is the first item.
You know what? It's actually true.
It is bad news.
Here's the video game news. Everything's getting delayed. The Last Guardian, which is that game that was shown in 2009 for the PS3, got delayed from from October 25th to December 6th. Shuhei Yoshida came out on stage. Or didn't come out on stage, but he came out and said that they just needed to delay it to fix the bugs. And at this point, I've waited so long for that video game.
Was it really 2009?
It was first shown at the E3 in 2009. So that's a hot 7 years ago. I was 14 when that game was announced. So
I was 12.
I don't know how some game developers think that's logical game progression, because... Like you, if it was for a certain age demographic,
yeah.
By the time they've announced it to produced it, they've completely missed the initial target. If that's what they were trying to do.
I mean, they kind of,
if it's a broad appeal, then
I think it's
fine,
more of a broad appeal.
I think this game is a broad appeal.
Yeah,
game.
And that's when it can sort of do that, but.
Mm-hmm. But still, I get that's a good point.
Yeah.
Whatever, that bird dog is going to die in the end. I already know the game. There's no doubt in my mind that bird dog doesn't make it till the end. Or does make it till the end.
This really is a dun-dun-dun.
Yeah, speaking of games getting delayed, Bloodstained Ritual of the Night, which is supposed to be the new Symphony of the Night, kind of spiritual successor. It's done by, oh crap, the guy who does Castlevania. Forget his name. I'm pretty tired. That one has been delayed from 2017, like early 2017, to 2018.
That's like not having confidence in yourself.
That's just a big delay.
It's like we're not even close to that. Yeah. Let's delay it a whole nother year.
And it's kind of scary because this is a Kickstarter. So this just is so dangerous. Reminiscent of like the Mighty Number 9 fiasco, where that game was delayed a ton and then it sucked. You can check out my review at Kaleo.org. Killing it.
Plugging. Shameless plugs.
Hey, whatever. But yeah, it's pretty crazy. That's a pretty crazy delay, but I have so much hope because, man, Symphony of the Night is so good. That's kind of that game that I play like every year. That's like
your Infamous.
Yeah, that's like, you know, that movie that people watch like once a year during Christmas. Like, I'll play Symphony of the Night once a year. Mm-hmm. And it's on so many different consoles, it's pretty easy to do. But yeah, I mean, man, this delay. These delays.
I know, that's kind of what they did with Mass Effect too. They delayed it a year when it first was announced. Yeah,
that's right. Mm-hmm. Speaking of Mass Effect. Segways! Killing it today. Woo. You want to take this one?
Yeah, so on more Mass Effect Andromeda details, but every time it's a detail, it's not really a detail, it's just like that. I actually knew this, though, from a Reddit leak.
I didn't know this.
Because I have Google Alerts set up for Mass Effect.
So, wowzers!
So every week I get new Mass Effect news, even if it's from the dark places of the internet. Anyway, so...
Oh. Gross.
We're not going to talk about that.
Rule 34. What's the Mass Effect news?
Mass Effect news is we have more information on some of the lead characters. So it's a brother and sister combination, and with their last name is Ryder. If you look really closely in the announced trailer, the one where they're like going to space and it's just that casual footage, there's actually a dog tag that says Ryder. That's how I knew that. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, so they're just not as cool as Shepard.
Yeah, let's talk about the real issue at hand. Ryder is definitely not as cool as Shepard.
No, it's not. Do you know where Shepard, where they got that from, too?
No.
So they got that Shepard, he was, I forget his first name, but he was one of the first people on the moon. So he wasn't obviously Neil Armstrong, Buzz Aldrin, but he came right after them, one of the Apollos.
You can't name him Armstrong.
Yeah, that's too obvious. Yeah.
That just has to be too weird. Like, Armstrong is kind of a weird last name.
Yeah.
Shepard is...
Shepard
is
good.
Shepard.
Commander Shepard.
Shepard. You can't do Ryder.
Ryder. Again.
Hey there, Ryder. Sounds like a Western.
No, that's why it was Western themed.
Oh, yeah, that's right. What's your first name for your Mass Effect character?
Grayson.
Grayson Ryder?
Yeah.
That's a pretty cool one.
It was Grayson Shepard, so I'm just going to carry it over.
Yeah. Oh, that makes sense.
I get it from Dick Grayson. Yeah.
Oh, from
Batman.
Batman.
Yeah. My child is going to be Grayson.
Wow, you really like that name.
I am committed. Even if it's a girl, Grayson.
Oof.
Yeah.
Well, then it can be Grayson can be kind of...
You can change it a little.
Can be
unisex. Yeah.
Yeah.
I always named my characters Kevin, but I think... I think I kind of fell out of that.
Like, you set that up. Like,
like, every character that you can name in, like, an RPG or something, I've always just named it Kevin. I don't know why...
I wonder why. Maybe is it because it's...
It is depressing. And, like, it's just so weird seeing your, like, name all over the place. So I stopped doing that. Now I'll just go with the default name.
What is the default name?
I don't know. Just, you know.
There's default names?
Yeah, for sure. If you don't put anything, you just hit enter, it'll go to, like, the default.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It was, like, Jane Shepherd or John Shepherd.
Yeah. I think it was John... Jane? I don't know.
Jane and John.
Yeah, so I'm probably not going to go with Kevin Ryder. Though, that's a cool freaking name.
That is, though.
Kevin Ryder. Yeah.
Wesley Ryder. Can you do Wesley Ryder?
No, I think it has to be Wes Ryder. Wes Ryder.
I never put my name in because it just doesn't match anything. Yeah. Tizana Ryder.
I think Tizana only matches Saldania.
Yeah, it does. Yeah. My mom got really lucky.
Match made in heaven there.
Yeah. My mom made up my name, so.
Hey,
it
worked, though.
Yeah. Shout out to my mom.
I mean, I didn't know how to pronounce your name for...
I know when people don't know how very to pronounce my time. Name because they just never say my name. Yeah. They just like stare at me and they're like, hey.
Hey, you.
Like, can you, Pam? Like, they don't know how to say my name.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Did you know how to say my name? I introduced myself to you.
Yeah, you introduced yourself to me. So
you didn't say my name at all.
Well, because I only knew you from an email, so I'm like, I'm just going to wait till she says her own name, and then I'll be good. Yeah. I've done enough screw-ups during interviews. Talking about, well, all right, I didn't couldn't segue into this one. Super Mario is getting an infinite runner that is, like, backed by Nintendo. This isn't, like, a weird Flash game someone made on Kongregate. This is, like, a real Nintendo-branded infinite runner.
This was on Apple's launch day event, so...
Yeah. Hey, you guys want to talk about the new iPhone?
And how much I'm not getting it?
What? Dude, it has headphone jack. Oh, yeah.
So, I mean, that's more...
Do you have an iPhone or an Android?
I have an iPhone 5.
Oh.
So, I'm a little behind the curve. I'm a little due, but I'm also super poor, so yeah. I'm probably not going to get one.
No, I like my iPhone 6. I'm pretty okay with it. It's the first 6, and I'm good with that.
I don't... Yeah. It has no headphone jack.
Isn't that disturbing?
It's so weird. You need, like, an adapter to get your headphone in there now, or you just do Bluetooth, but...
Did you see the... Why are they so long coming out, the pod things?
Because it's got the battery and the wireless transceiver.
Like, I'm thinking as a girl, you too have long hair. Like, it can just knock out if your hair touches it.
Oh,
it's
long.
It doesn't, like, go in. It's like...
Ooh. Yeah, that's all... There's, like, a whole listing of all the posts following the announcement, and people were like, I looked at these, and I already lost one.
That's great.
Then someone else took, like, the previous headphones and, like, cut off the wires and said, oh, look, I have the new earbuds.
I'm too poor to buy one, so I guess might as well not even talk about it, but...
Someone asked me, like, what I thought about this weekend, the Super Mario getting on the phone, and then they're comparing it to Pokemon Go, how, like, video games are coming over to iPhones, and they were saying they don't like it because they think that it's ruining consoles. And it's becoming more into, and I was like, well, I mean I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, if Nintendo makes a lot of money off of this, then they can make a better console, or they can make more games, or they can just be alive longer.
It's burned against the best argument he made. We had a debate over the best console.
Remember this. Yeah.
And you argued for the Wii.
The Wii U is a good console. Whatever. I still think I'm right. So this is coming out. It looks like a pretty normal infinite runner, but hey, there's Mario, and there's Mario power-ups, and the masses will love that because Mario is the only thing that people can recognize. You know, when my grandma says, she doesn't say, do you play video games? She says, do you play the Mario?
I knew you were going to put the Mario, too.
Yeah.
I was feeling the obvious. Mario.
The Mario, yeah. So
my mom played, like, Sega growing up, or when she was in the 90s. She was in the
90s. So does she say, do you play the Sonic?
She's like, do you play the Sega?
Oh, okay.
And I was like, no. But
you play those Nintendos?
Nintendos.
Play the Nintendo?
Yeah, Super Mario, it's going to be good.
I mean, yeah, I think it's a smart move by Nintendo. They'll make a crap ton of money off of this.
Well, and they've stated that's their aim is to move into the mobile marketplace.
Yeah, I mean, that's
capture some of those revenues.
That's still what we think the NX might be, is a more mobile platform.
Yeah.
But they're also doing that stuff with, like, the Animal Crossing mobile game and the Fire Emblem mobile thing. Yeah. I don't know if it's going to be a full-fledged Animal Crossing game or if it's just going to be, like, some dumb app. But,
wait, what?
Yeah, this was talked about at, like, a Nintendo Direct or something a while ago. While you Google
Animal Crossing and stuff coming onto iPhone.
Yeah, something like that. I don't know.
If this is how it looks stupid.
Yeah, I mean, it just looks like a normal, like, app thing. That's, That's not it. Okay. We'll just move on from this. We'll just keep trucking. Really, well, this is your news story, so I don't know how
Oh, is it mine next?
You're up next.
Did you guys play the Arkham series at all? Any of the Arkham games? Okay. Wesley, what do you play?
Wesley,
like RTS.
Yeah.
RTS.
Oh, okay.
So, not really.
Okay, but you know what the Arkham
series is. Definitely. I've seen some of
that. So, they're gonna...
Sorry. I got a text.
From a Hey Kevin. Look at that. Is that a chick?
It is. Keep going.
I know how girl. Anyway, right
in. Moving on.
She's sliding right in
into my freaking podcast.
I like how you didn't have her number saved.
I don't have anyone's number saved. Who puts names on numbers? That's way too hard.
like every human being.
Yeah. No! I can just look through context and I know who it is. Player. Through the message. You know, Wesley also was...
He's got too many girls texting
me. Yeah, look at you.
Wesley was also astounded that I'd never sent a letter before.
Yeah, I know.
That, so you can read, like, but you can't send a letter?
That just seems weird to me. Letters are dumb.
No, they're not. They're beautiful.
Text is beautiful.
I hate texting.
We can just text. It's the 21st century.
Hate texting.
Who sends letters? Who do you send letters to?
Family. And it's funny because I live with my family, so
just like, let me stick this in the mailbox.
No,
back.
I just like throw it on the paper airplane, but I have a weird house. So they can, like, there's a courtyard and it just, I still do that though.
Are you in the Brady Bunch?
Essentially.
Okay.
Anyways,
Batman.
Batman has a Brady Bunch, doesn't he, with all those Robins? So the Arkham series, they're remastering it and calling it Batman Returns to Arkham. Just, you know, for the PS4, all three. They're not including Arkham Origins because it sucked. No. But
whoa.
Arkham Origins sucked.
Arkham Origin wasn't that bad. I mean, it wasn't good, but
comparable to the Rocksteady ones. It
sure,
sucked.
But if you don't compare it to
them, it's okay.
Then it's just a fine video game.
Yeah.
You could play as Deadshot.
Yeah, Deadshot.
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 I got it right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I was just guessing.
And Deathstroke.
Deathstroke.
And Deadshot.
And
you
Deadshot.
Can you play as Deadshot?
No, I think I was talking about Deathstroke.
But there is Deadshot in the game.
Sure. Okay. Yes. Probably.
No, I've seen.
Anyway, so just if you there's actually video how it's gonna look. It started already. No, yeah, it's gonna have video of how it looks versus the PS3 and on the PS4. It's actually a really big difference if you look at Arkham Asylum versus it. Looks a lot better. That's pretty much the only news, and it just has a release date now of October 18th.
That's cool.
How are women texting you?
It's a good question.
Oh, I want to know.
Because he only texts, he doesn't have to be in person.
Right.
See?
Have you hung out with this chick before?
Yes. You guys are being very rude right now. You don't think I read. You think I'm some illiterate dum-dum.
And you're burping on camera. Like, yeah, we're just taking...
What? Pause. Holding it in is unhealthy. Speaking of remasters...
How did I get signed?
What are you trying to say, Agatha? Agatha, say what is on your mind. This is a podcast.
Agatha and I have actually talked about you behind your back.
Man, this is just rude. I don't know why I do this. I'm gonna find
podcast. We've said good things.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes, and we've said good things about. We have said good things. It's all positive.
Mm-hmm. New video games coming out. My voice is going to be so loud on this recording.
Yep.
Speaking of remasters, BioShock is getting a remaster, or has had a remaster, and it is coming out on September 13, which is tomorrow, probably today when this podcast goes up. But yeah, that'll be coming out on the PlayStation 4, the Xbox One, and the PC, and I think they're only remastering the first two games.
Yeah, I'd heard from some friends that it didn't look like they were really improving much.
Yeah, well, especially for the Infinite, BioShock Infinite.
But even the first two, it just, like, the slight changes.
Yeah.
Like, if you already own the games,
I am that
worth
person
it.
Who's never played BioShock.
I haven't.
What?
Either.
What?
Now you guys have something on me. I've never played BioShock.
I haven't played
it. Well, this just seems crazy. BioShock is a fantastic video game series. BioShock 2, not so much. Then BioShock Infinite was also not super great, but it was pretty good.
I remember buying BioShock, the one where there's like the interracial couple, and then something happens. What is that one? Which one is that? Is that Infinite?
I have no idea.
It's like, it's a cloudy kingdom. Like, it's a weird
world. Oh, that's Infinite.
Yeah, oh, okay. Infinite, yeah. I was playing that once when it first came out, and I just didn't like how immediately I had to saw someone's face after that. And I just returned it because it was just too violent.
It's a pretty gruesome game.
I was young. Now I can handle it. Maybe I should get into this.
Young? How old were you when BioShock Infinite came out?
Let me Google. I'm not good with numbers.
Young? I was like 16 or 17 when that game came out.
I am younger than you.
That's true.
Yeah.
These are all facts.
Yeah.
Speaking of more new video games coming out, ReCore came out, or is coming out again on September 13th for the Xbox One and PlayStation. I'm sorry, and PC. And ReCore is a weird game that I don't really know a whole bunch about. So, sorry. Can't really
give you... I was 14.
You're 14?
I was 14.
That is pretty young.
Yeah. 13 going to 14. Sauce
it through someone's face, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, ReCore is kind of a game where you can... You control a bunch of different kinds of robots, and you put your core in them to kind of control them.
It's cute.
It has terrible ratings, though.
Oh.
Does it? Yeah. I remember watching that.
64? That's above average.
Okay. But it has a 4 out of 10 on Destructoid. Yeah.
Oh.
I remember seeing the E3 for this and thinking it was so cute, but then it would be better as a movie.
Oh, and yeah.
It looks like it would be better as a movie. I can see that.
Yeah.
It'd be easy enough. Honestly, a lot of these video games would be easy enough to turn into a movie.
I mean, they are movies.
Essentially.
Yeah.
With a little bit of your own self-derived action, but...
Yeah. Like, Last of Us is a movie, but it's a good game, too.
Yeah, Last of Us is a cinematic experience.
Yep.
And is also fantastic. Man, I should go back and play The Last of Us
That's
again.
Another game. See, I didn't think that was violent, though. I don't know why I didn't think that was
The Last of Us is pretty violent.
It's like more violent than BioShock. How old was that in Last
I don't think it's more violent. I just think it's more...
It also
dark.
Had a brutal beginning.
It's
too.
More realistic. Oh, yeah, that
the
was...
beginning broke my heart.
Yeah.
I should get that remastered, though. That's a really good game.
I was
game.
The same age when Last of Us came out. How did I not think that that was violent?
I don't think it was violent. I think, well, I mean, there were violent parts, but I think BioShock was more gruesome.
Yeah, this
But
is...
this was more, like, tonally dark.
Yeah, it was...
And violent. But the most violent it gets is when those things will eat your face off.
Yeah, and if you're good at it, then that doesn't happen.
The clickers.
So often. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good game.
Favorite game.
Iced coffee. Alright, last new release of the day is Dragon Quest VII, Fragments of the Forgotten Past, which isn't a new release technically. It is a game that's being remade for the Nintendo 3DS and will be coming out in North America on September 16. I've never played a Dragon Quest game.
Really?
That's all I can say about Dragon Quest. I mean, it's a pretty prolific RPG series in Japan. Yeah, but maybe I should jump in. I know there's another Dragon Quest game that's being re-released in the future. But
no, never played a Dragon Quest either.
I've never played a Dragon Quest game. No. Slimes. That's all I know about Dragon Quest. There are slimes. So that's coming out September 16. I might just get it to play something on my 3DS. It's been so long.
Agatha is sending me photos.
I've opened
right now.
My 3DS.
Oh, wow. Sorry, I didn't mean to mention that. I'm sorry.
Agatha,
she didn't say anything. There's nothing.
Going crazy in the corner. Hey, Wesley, do you have a question?
I'm not looking at them yet. I exit out because you scared
me. I mean, technically.
Technically.
Oh, do you have a question?
No, I don't.
Oh.
Wesley, it's your turn.
Just
think of something right now. Let's talk about Animal Crossing Wild World when he thinks of it. Because Animal Crossing is so cute.
I couldn't get into that last Animal Crossing game.
The New Leaf one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I couldn't get into... I actually have the 3DS that has the Pop-Tart looking thing. Like, that was meant for the...
Finger guns?
Yeah,
it was meant for the finger guns?
Yeah, it was this one. Hold on. I can't remember. It was a long time ago.
I just couldn't get into the fact that it was, like, all real time. And that, like, I would have to wait, like, a real day before my house was built.
Isn't every Animal Crossing like that?
No.
Not the GameCube one, but every one after that.
Oh, yeah. Well, I only liked the GameCube one, really.
I never played... I was too young for the
what?
GameCube one.
The GameCube one is the best one.
I know it's the best one, but I was too young for it.
Oh, the GameCube was such a good console. I don't know if I'm, like, a Nintendo apologist, but I really like the GameCube as a console.
There, I have that one, the Pop-Tart.
Oh, wow. That's a pretty cool 3DS.
Yeah, it was expensive.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That was like the collector's edition one?
Yep. That was the first thing I ever bought for myself.
The first thing?
That was the first thing I ever bought for myself.
With your own money?
With my own money after
wow.
I got a job.
How many lawns did you have to mow to?
I actually was a teacher.
What?
I was a Kimon teacher.
What's Kimon?
That thing where they make you do...
Kimon! Sorry, go ahead.
The thing where they make you do like those packets, those learning packets, those learning centers.
No idea.
You're lucky. They have the little blue folders and they carry them. Okay.
I went to public school.
I went to public school too.
Hey, we're back. We had some technical difficulties. We went too long. Wesley, do you have a question for the crew?
Well, I guess...
Oh, by the way, it's versus mode time.
Yeah, but not really like a super duper difficult one.
That's cool.
It's fine.
Actually,
it's
I'm going to revive a question that we had last semester.
All right, yeah, one in doubt.
That's an unfair advantage, then.
One in doubt, go back to the well.
To be fair, he did get trounced in this one.
Whoa.
I love your trounced.
Trounced.
Wesley's rhetoric, bringing that back.
Pwned. Remember when that was a thing?
P-W-N-E-D.
Pwned, you noob. Man, I'm happy we've moved on from those days. Hey, what's your question, Wesley?
What do you think is the best console?
Oh come on. I already know what he's going to argue with.
Well, that's not true anymore.
Okay.
I really don't think it is.
What if we have the same answer?
Yeah, what's your favorite?
PlayStation 2.
Oh, we don't have the same answer.
Okay.
Super Nintendo.
Okay.
Yeah.
He can go first.
Well, you answered first, so.
I'm tired of doing that.
She doesn't like being
them the rules.
I don't like being first. I had a librarian once tell me never go first.
Yeah.
It's
my strategy.
That's exactly what I would think a librarian would say.
Right?
Never go first.
Like, stay in the back.
Stay in the back.
Yep.
Be quiet. Don't talk.
Exactly. So I guess I'll go first then.
Okay. You ready to go?
Yeah.
All right. Tres, dos, uno.
That's the most white way to say.
Your time is running.
I can't just restart it because I'm thinking of you and failing your Spanish.
All right.
Anyway, okay, let's go.
Go.
So the PlayStation 2 is one of the best consoles because PlayStation 1 already kind of brought in a bunch of new players into the gaming world. It came in at a good time in the 90s, and it was really advertised unlike any other console. And PlayStation 2 was one of the first, and it had the same name, so we knew it was a part of the same lineage, and it carried a lot of the same titles that were on the PlayStation 1 into that 2000s era, so a bunch of new gamers were growing up with it. So it's not like things that came in the 80s where they're kind of getting older now. This was for people who were born in the 90s and late 80s and growing up with it. And it basically propelled how we have modern video gaming today, whereas the Nintendo is still trying to keep up. It's iconic. It's iconic. I'm not saying that it's not iconic, but the PlayStation was on the cutting edge of pushing next gen forward.
Cool. You good?
Yeah, I'm good.
That's pretty good.
Thank you.
I'm worried. All right, I'm going to start my own timer.
Bring out that rhetoric.
All right.
Yeah.
So the Super Nintendo, I think it's maybe the best console because of also its controllers. You remember those controllers? How freaking cool. I feel like the Super Nintendo was the one console that really got controllers right. It had enough buttons. It had a really solid gamepad. It had good shoulder buttons. But then also the Super Nintendo had such iconic video games on it. You have Legend of Zelda, The Link to the Past. You have Super Mario World. You have Super Metroid. These are really the IPs that kind of got Nintendo started and into its development cycle and really pumping out solid first-party games. The Super Nintendo also was a lot of people's first console. I mean, that came out in, you know, the mid-90s, and it's kind of what a lot of people grew up with. I know I grew up with the Super Nintendo, and, you know, it's your first console, and it really made a great impact on people, and I think kind of got them started into a gaming lifestyle because it had such good video games on it. Time.
Did you guys want to do a rebuttal?
Man, I love the PlayStation 2, though, so it's really hard for me to do a rebuttal against that.
Or, I mean, if Tizana wanted to add anything first, and then if you wanted to add anything.
Yeah, Tizana.
Well, just because it's iconic, why does that make it good, though? What did it add besides being iconic?
I think it got a lot of people started into the video game, into the video game, you know, series. And you can say the same thing about the PlayStation.
Yeah.
Why? It's just because it's iconic.
It's just later.
Yeah.
We kind of have a similar argument, just change the date. So.
Yeah.
I think the PlayStation is just better because it was propelling. And we still have the PlayStation. It keeps going. So it kind of has been a cornerstone.
We still have Nintendo.
Yeah, but it's not a place. You know, they tried the Wii. They tried the thing. They've tried many other things.
You're
PlayStation
right. They tried.
Yeah.
Unlike the PlayStation, which just goes with its old, we're the PlayStation, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we got the neat or the pro.
I know.
Boy, that's an embarrassment. Hey, why don't we make the console system like a PC? Like, oh, you have to buy new things to upgrade it. Why wouldn't you just buy a PC at that point?
Well, because a PlayStation goes.
Sony tarnished all of the goodwill. Nah, the PlayStation 2 is a great console. I think the Super Nintendo is a better console.
I thought the PlayStation, I mean, you could say the same thing for the Xbox, but I thought the PlayStation offered different types of gaming at that time, like different avenues that gaming could go in. Because you had Crash Bandicoot, which, you know, I did that article on. You had Crash Bandicoot, you had racing games, you had, what is that other one? His name is Snake.
Metal Gear Solid.
Yeah. And yeah, you just had a bunch of different stuff that was coming off on one console.
Yeah, but dude, the Super Nintendo had
some of the most
iconic video games of all time.
I know, but they're just Super iconic Mario because World? They were first.
That's no, what, it's because they're really good video
they're
games.
They're really good, but okay.
Super Mario World is still maybe the best designed platformer I've ever played. And man, the Super Nintendo did pixel art right. It did the 16-bit graphic style.
I love it too.
So well.
This is hard. This is a hard
question.
Isn't this
a fun question? Yeah.
Because I agree with all of that, too.
It's hard to, like, choose the answer as well.
Well, I don't know. Last time, no one agreed with me because they didn't think the Wii U was a good console.
The Wii U is a good console.
It
is, but when it's compared against its competition.
What was it compared against?
I just don't think it has good games.
I don't know if it's PlayStation or what.
I thought it was great because you could take the controller anywhere, like the bathroom.
Exactly. That would have been my argument.
That was my argument.
It's great.
Wesley, you're given the unfortunate...
Judging, so.
Yeah, it was Ikeika judging. That dude hated the Wii.
You were kind of blown out of the water to begin with.
Yeah. But now you have to make
Wesley,
this hard decision.
You picked a hard question, so now you have to pick
a
hard answer.
I have the very hard answer. Yeah.
Yeah.
See, I've played on both. Briefly. See, it's more like, it is kind of like the iconic or the introduction of cross-compatibility, which has carried on through all consoles, except the Wii.
Except Nintendo.
Except Nintendo. But they do a good effort of remaking stuff, but...
Yeah, and I think I like how Nintendo always tries new stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, the Wii was so weird and crazy, and it actually really succeeded for them. I mean, Wii Sports is still the best-selling video game of all time. And, you know, the Wii U, also super weird. They had a freaking gamepad. Like, that was just...
I just think nobody knows how to design a game for the Wii U. Because you could really do some great stuff with that.
You know what? I thought there were a few games that did really cool stuff. Like, Splatoon, I thought was really cool.
Yeah,
it's creative, yeah.
It's super creative. And that's what I've always loved about Nintendo, is that even though they're weird, they're always really creative. Mm-hmm. Like, Pikmin is such a weird game.
It is a weird game.
And Shigeru Miyamoto was just high on mushrooms, looking through his garden. He's like, you know what would be a cool video game? If I have little men in my garden. And he looks.
No, he saw his garden gnome
start
jumping around.
And he's like, whoa, I am tripping.
We're still filming, don't worry, we're good.
Have you come to an answer, Wesley? We're running pretty late.
I think I'm going to give you your first point of the semester. I like both of your answers, though.
Yeah, it's. I don't blame you at all.
Thank you.
Yeah. So.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is the longest Pixel Power Up we've ever had. We're almost running into 40 minutes. Agatha just wants to go home.
Yep.
Agatha f***ing hates us right now.
This is going to be a pain edit, man.
It will be a pain to edit.
Yeah,
but
there's a few brief rough spots.
We keep offering to help. Well, I keep offering to help.
I don't know. Like, sharing editing is kind of weird. Just because then you have to share all the files. And, you know, it's cool. I like to edit. And speaking of me, I got to get better at these segues. I'm going to segue my way out of this podcast. This has been Kevin Allen, and say your names.
Wesley Babcock.
And Susanna Saldana.
And we are the Pixel Power Up, and we're signing out. Goodbye.
See you next time.